Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team, and today I'm going to be going over how you can use some of NX's out-of-the-box validation tools to perform quality assurance tests on your parts and assemblies. To do this, we are going to start with this coffee machine and take a deeper look at analyzing the shell casing on the machine's outside. I have already isolated the subassembly in a new window, and the first thing I'm going to do is start up the Checkmate tool found under HD 3D Tools. This is where we will be able to find all of our test results when we run our quality assurance checks. Now that we have opened our Checkmate tab under HD 3D Tools, the next thing we are going to do is begin to set up our tests. To do this, we can open the Developer tab from the top of the screen and select the Setup Tests icon. When this is done, the first thing we will be prompted with is to determine the scope of our analysis. We can either choose to look at the current part, all loaded parts, or all of the parts found within a single folder. For this scenario, the current part option is all we need. With our scope now selected, we can now choose which tests will be run. I'm going to select a variety of tests to help demonstrate a few areas where these quality assurance tests can assist your productivity. As you may notice, there is a large number of options to choose from, ranging from information checks, modeling, assemblies, PMI, and requirements. This ensures that the majority of frequent use cases are already covered in the out-of-the-box Checkmate tests. With 5 tests selected now, we are ready to execute our tests and analyze the results. When I run our tests, the first thing that stands out is that there is 3 different icons next to our tests. The blue eye signifies the test resulted in an information message. The green arrow means the test was skipped, and the green checks mean that the test had a successful result. The first test, which was ran, was a simple information check to analyze how many components are in our subassembly. To see this result, we can right-click on the test case and select Show Info View. Doing this will bring in a new window with more information on the test results. When I do this, we can see that there were 12 different parts within this subassembly. Looking at the next test, we can see that there is a green arrow next to it, signifying the test was skipped. However, this is because in our assembly, we have no sketches to check. After this, the next two tests have green checks, signaling the checks performed successfully without error. To confirm they tested for what was intended, I'm going to right-click and once again select Show Info View. Once this is opened, if we hit More Detail at the bottom, we can take a look at the test descriptions and parameters. Here we can find a more detailed explanation what is tested for, as well as the values that were tested. The last test here is a check feature tolerance test. When I open the Show Info View window, we can see that our tolerances all passed for acceptable values. To find our tolerance value limit, we can look under the parameters by once again selecting More Detail. To review what we have looked at, we began by exploring how to set up a few Checkmate tests using the out-of-the-box pre-made options. After that, we executed our tests and began reviewing our results by utilizing the Show Info View option when we right-clicked on each individual test. And lastly, we further explored our test results by selecting the More Detail button found at the bottom of the Show Info View window. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.